I'm going to start by just gluing this area here. And again, don't do too much, otherwise the glue will dry before you get round to using it. If you're working with new glass and you're not using chips to, or you're not using up chips, you can place the pieces on like that and measure where you need to cut. So you can trace through the mosaic that's underneath. So you know that this here is the piece that you need to fill in that gap. However, if you're using pieces like this, you can just slot them in like we've been doing with the green in other places. I'm going to use these, but I'm going to mix them up. Right, so I can see what I've got. And I'm going to start filling in now. If you don't think you've got enough glue, this one's slightly textured, this glass. In fact, it's more textured on one side than the other. Make sure there's enough glue in there for your pieces. Ooh, there's a splinter under there, I can hear it. Fortunately, I can't see it, so I'm just guessing. Bit more glue in there. Hope I found it. Just do what you were doing, lower down in the mosaic and trimming the pieces to actually fit the gaps. Check every now and again that the gaps haven't been filled up with glue where you've been moving them around. Just check before you move on to the top, these two pieces here need filling. I'm going to use some of this clear glass here to run some clouds across the top. So I just want to clean it first. Now the glass is clean, I'm going to mark it where I want to cut. This is a softly textured glass and I want to use that for the upper surface. I'm marking on the textured side, but I'm going to turn over and cut on the smooth side. Using your glass cutter, just smooth lines top to bottom, break that one, and now these. The lines are only a guide, you don't have to follow them exactly, and break out the pieces that you want to use. You don't have to worry about the pen marks because they're on the upper surface. Spread out any wet glue that you have. Adding more where necessary. Once again, don't put too much on because you're very close to the finish and you don't want to waste a lot of glue. Now we're going to put the clouds in, textured side up, and make sure that black line is on the upper surface. If not, it'll get stuck into the mosaic and you won't be able to get it out. This way, the black line will clean off at the end. Now I've put quite a lot of glue down here because it's a bigger piece of glass, and when I want to press it in, I want to make it completely transparent. You can see the glue through it. Push. Wiggle and push out all those air bubbles until it's completely transparent. That's what you're after. Next, now just hold it while you take out the glue and leave that there for the next piece. Spread it out. It's a little thicker than the rest of it, but you can take out anything you squish out. Again, make sure textured side up, pen marks on the top, and push in. Wiggle, push out all the air bubbles until it's really transparent. That's it. Now you can take out the excess glue that you pushed out from under these pieces of glass. Spread it out, making sure it's not too deep, because again the blue glass is in smaller pieces. And also check that you haven't filled up any gaps. Now you can continue with your sky. And just keep going until you've filled up right to the top. We're on the very last piece now, which I'm just marking and trimming. And I've got a little bit of glue just on that upper cloud, which I'll dip into to make sure this has enough underneath. There we go, and in it goes. And that's it. That is your mosaic complete. Now you need to clean it up, make sure there's no glue filling up the gaps, and remove any areas of really sticky glue on the top that's quite chunky. Smears and small pieces, don't worry about, that will come out at the end when we've grouted and washed and polished the finished mosaic. The next video will be grouting and cleaning, followed by the last short one of checking the edges for sharp pieces and polishing.